So today we want to talk a little bit about graphing, and I just want to remind you of graphing techniques for some of the most typical functions that we will encounter in this class. So one of the first things that we want to talk about graphing is lines or linear functions. So a linear function looks like f of x is equal to mx plus b. This is a linear function. And you probably more likely remember being y is equal to mx plus b. In this form, this is called the slope-intercept form. Of a line. This gives me the slope m and b is the y-intercept. Okay, so I want to just go ahead and do an example and graph one of those for you. So I think let's do an example graph the line f of x is equal to 1/2 x minus 2. Okay, so I'm going to set up my coordinate axes here. And draw some tick marks. You need to label your graphs very carefully, please, in this class. Graphs can communicate a lot of information, but only if they're drawn clearly. So, and when I graph this, which I'll do in blue ink, I go here, the y-intercept is here, y is equal to negative 2, and that's really the point, x is 0, y negative 2. So I go to that point right here, and I have a dot. And then from that dot, I have this slope. Slope is 1/2. Now, you might remember it rise over run, or the change in y over change in x, but this tells me how y changes, and the 2 tells me how x changes. So I'm going to go up 1 and to the right by 2. So up 1, let me do this in blue ink, up 1 and to the right by 2. And you see these little tick marks as I'm doing that, up 1 and to the right by 2. And you can get as many points as you need to go that way. And then we'll just draw a line. Connect the dots. It keeps going. Down 1 and to the left by 2 is also. Looks something like this. Okay? This is the graph of the equation y is equal to 1/2 x minus 2. Now there are some specific points that I want to make sure that you recognize from this graph. So let's move it up. We know this point was called the y-intercept, this point 0, negative 2 is the y-intercept. It's the place where the graph crosses the y-axis. Okay? Now I can find that point by letting x equal to 0 in the equation or in the function. Okay? So in my original function, I had f of x is equal to 1/2 x minus 2. If I find f of 0 and let x be 0, I get 1/2 times 0 minus 2, and that's equal to negative 2. That's my y-intercept. Okay? Now there's another point, or in this case one more point, x-intercept, right here at the point 4, 0 is the x-intercept. The x-intercept is where the graph crosses the x-axis, okay? And the x-axis, the equation of the x-axis is the line y is equal to 0, so I find by letting y equal to 0 or f of x equal to 0. So let me go down and do that. I just want to get a little more room to do that algebra. So here, my original f of x again is 1 half x minus 2. Or you can think of it as y is equal to 1 half x minus 2. To find the x-intercept, I let this y be 0 and solve for x. So, and we go back up. I just want to connect this with the graph that we saw. That should be the point 4, which if you see on the graph, that is where my line is crossing the x-axis. So those are two points. They're not specific to lines. We can have x and y intercepts for other functions, and you find them just in this manner. Let y is equal to 0 to find x-intercepts. Let x equal to 0 to find y-intercepts. Okay? The other thing that I want to maybe talk about real quickly is domain and range from this graph. So valid inputs and outputs. For linear functions, domain should be, and for all polynomial functions, domain should be minus infinity to infinity. There's no problem plugging in any real number in there. And for linear functions where the slope isn't 0, the range is also this, minus infinity to infinity. And you can kind of see that in this graph, that this line will continue to go down in the left direction and up in the right direction, and should eventually hit any real number that we want. Okay, so let's go down. I just want to talk about a couple other special types of lines, but hopefully that jogs your memory about graphing in slope-intercept form. We also have horizontal lines. These lines have slope equal to 0. Okay, there's no change in y, and they take the form y is equal to some number b. So, for example, the equation y is equal to 5, or similarly, f of x is equal to 5, is a horizontal line. And we can come down and graph it pretty easily. And I get this graph right here. It has a y-intercept of 5, and then it just goes straight across from there. And every point, the y-value is 5. Okay, so finally I want to talk about vertical lines. Vertical lines have undefined slope, or take the form x is equal to some number c. They have slope is undefined. So for example, x is equal to 3. This is a line that's straight up and down. Again, please be intentional about your graphs and their neatness. But this is a line that goes straight up and down at the x value of 3. Okay? Okay, so that's a little bit about lines, and we'll talk about quadratic functions in the next video. Please let me know if you have questions.